Okay, what about the others? I guess shrimps, now you have an idea about what is shrimps, right? Yes. So Meghna, yes, we can start with you. After that, Nidhi, okay? Okay, Meghna.
First one is a top. In that, the trims have zipper and sweater and the lining. And in that dart, I have the back and front dart.
Okay. Waistline dart?
Waistline.
Okay, waistline dart. Single dart.
Yes. Then next four trims, they have swing thread. It's simple top, almost waist, till waist.
Sorry, I didn't get you.
It's a top till the waist, a normal top.
Okay.
It's the trim is only swing thread.
Swing
and
thread.
The dart, neck dart.
Neck dart, okay.
Then
no,
next one.
No other embellishments, nothing.
Nothing.
Simple. Okay,
simple. Next one is a top which has the net here, neck area, and it has net and the sewing thread. For that, it has only back dart.
Back dart only, okay.
Then it's a kurti. It's that the trims, sewing thread, lace, motifs, and lining.
Okay, okay.
I didn't get it that, so I left it.
Okay, okay.
The next one is sweatpant, which has sewing thread, a zipper, and an elastic. And also that I didn't get it.
In sweatpants, there will be no dart because it is a drawstring will be there, right? In order to make it tight fitted. So it is just that. An elastic will be there inside, or maybe it is just drawstrings. Okay, so that drawstring is a what is a trim. If elastic is used, then that is a trim. Okay. Okay. Yes, Nidhi. You are done, right, Meghna?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Nidhi, are you there?
Searching for my presentation file. After that, I will do, ma'am.
Okay, 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 Nidhi. Malavika?
Yes, ma'am. The first one is a churidar. It is single darted. The trims present are thread, brand and size label, wash care instructions, lining, and embroidery will be in the trim, no, ma'am.
Embroidery is an embellishment, so I guess I don't know clearly, so I will just check it.
Okay, then kurta, it is single darted, then thread, buttons, brand and size label, wash care instructions, and lining are the trims. Then for long blouse, it is single darted, the trims present are thread, shell, and hook. Then for half blouse, it is double darted. The trims present are thread, hook, brand label, and a knot. Then for a dungaree or dress, it is single darted. And the trims present are buttons, size, label, wash care label, brand, and a knot.
Okay. Okay, Manavika. So we know how to develop. We don't know how to develop basic bodies, but we know the basic structure of basic bodies now, right? And you might have seen the basic structure. So the basic structure. Where is the pen? Yes. So basic structure of a basic skirt. Okay. Basic skirt is something like this. Okay. So here there will be a curve. So this is the basic structure of a basic skirt. Basic skirt. And we know how basic bodies looks. A single darted basic bodies look. Right. And if we combine this two, what will happen if we combine this two? Pattern for a dress is developed. Okay, pattern for a dress is developed. What if we want an A-line skirt or a A-line dress or a dress that is flared in the bottom? Then we will measure, we will calculate how much flare we want, and based on that we will extend this bottom part and we will extend this part, side seam and hem. Now we got flare, right? And how it will look if we, after we combining both these patterns? How will it look? It will look, if it is a flared one, then it will look something like this. It's the darts. Okay. This is dart. The same goes when it is a dart and a salwar kameez, a churidar or a kurti. Okay, this is how a kurti dart looks like, a dress dart look like. An A-line dress, maybe. This is how it looks like. So this is basically what? A dress and a skirt combined. Right. It is a tight fitted dress or not a flared dress, just a straight dress, then the pattern will be like this. Basic skirt and basic body skirt. So what is the necessity of understanding or knowing the right size, right measurement? You know, multiple sizes are available in the market, right? Extra small is there, small is there, medium size is there, large is there, extra large is there, double XL is there, then plus sizes are there, right? Okay. So what is the necessity of understanding the right size? And in some cases, yes, we do love to wear oversized clothes, plus size clothes. I do. I love to wear plus size clothes. Oversized hoodies, oversized t-shirt. I love to wear that. That is another case, completely different case. But we do love to wear, but we want to wear. We should wear something that fit us perfectly, right? So what used to happen before? We learned history of fashion, right? So what used to happen before Industrial Revolution? With Industrial Revolution, mass production was introduced. When different machineries got invented, mass production started happening, right? Ready to wear started to get, ready to wear garments were manufactured then after Industrial Revolution. So what used to happen before Industrial Revolution? Yes, Raina.
My message, Sharon, she have a home current went.
Okay, yes, yes, that's what happened here also. Electricity went. It's on way and it just came back. Okay, it's okay, fine. Yes. So what, how people used to buy garments or wear garments before Industrial Revolution? We discussed that in the class, okay? We have discussed it. So people used to collect their own fiber, they used to spin their own yarns, they used to weave their own fabric, and they used to stitch their own garment. And there were multiple draped garments over there. And apart from that, they used to stitch their own garment, right? Using hand sewing needles and threads, they used to sew. They used to stitch their own garments. And once new machineries got introduced, garments became more cheaper, mass production started, right? And that's how this ready-to-wear garments or apparel categories came into picture. Still, sometimes we go to the tailor and we get our salwar kameez, our kurtis, and some tops, shirts get stitched by them, right? So what is the difference between a tailored garment and the one that we buy from the market? What is the difference between both of them? What is the difference between both of them? The one we buy from the market, from a ready-to-wear brand or shop, retail shop, or and what is the difference between a tailored piece?
Malavi,
yes, Meghna. Yes, Meghna.
For tailored one, we have correct measurements of our body, so it can complement our body correctly. And for the ready to wear, maybe it may be some loose in some areas, and it may be the not the way we wanted. Like
yes,
maybe the neckline is too short or too long. Like
yes, yes, exactly. Right. So when we go to a tailor for to get something stitched, that they will take our measurements, right? Our shoulder measurements, our bust measurement, our waist measurement, how much length we want it to be. They will take everything. And they will stitch as per our requirements. The garment will be manufactured the way we want it to be, with the right and proper measurements, right? What happens when it comes to ready-to-wear? They have a set of measurements, basic measurements. Right. But can it fit us perfectly all the time? No. Right. Some of us will have broader shoulder, wide, broad shoulders. Some of us will be having wider hip. Right. Am I right? So we all are having different types of body types. We discussed about different body silhouettes, right? We discussed about different body silhouettes. Hourglass silhouettes are there. Rectangular silhouettes are there. Pear-shaped silhouettes are there. Like that, different types of body silhouettes. Just like garment silhouettes, different body silhouettes are also. We all are of different body types. So a garment, if I'm having a small shoulder, my shoulder is, if my shoulder is not that wide, and if my hip is too wide, and if I go for a small size, if I buy a small size kurti, what will happen? What will happen? My if just suppose if my bust is just 30 or 32, and what if my hip is just 38 or 40? I can't buy a smaller size, right? Because a smaller size kurti or dress, because it will not fit in my hip area. It will get stuck, or it will be too tight, restricting my movements. Right? It will roll up every time I sit or move. So that was not a perfect size for me. So I should buy a bigger size. A person with such a body type should buy a bigger size so that it can accommodate their bigger hip area also. And they can just make some alteration in the top shoulder area. So that is what happened when we go for a ready to wear. They will take a survey, they will take measurements of average population, and they will make this, the government or certain organizations will come up with this measurement chart. And based on this, they will develop garments. Okay. So will these measurements be accurate or same for all the brands?
No.
Will it be same for all the brands? No, right. There will be some variations. There will be some variations. Small size or large size, Levi's large size suit for me. I can buy a large size t-shirt from Levi's. It will not be the same when it goes to some other brands like UCB or anything else. It can and cannot be, right? It can and cannot. So what happened when we do online shopping? How will we, if we are doing offline shopping, yes, it is possible for us to try it out and find out what suits us better, which size suits us better, right? What happens if we are doing online shopping? What if we are doing online shopping?
We'll buy a sample.
Sorry, Raina?
We'll buy a trial one. Then we'll get returned.
Okay, so if you browse this online websites, we can see small, medium, large, XL and all. Apart from this, a size chart will be provided in the website. Size chart. Okay, a size chart will be provided. If you check that size chart, you will get to know a small size, the measurement, shoulder measurement, bust measurement, waist measurement, full length measurement of a smaller size, medium size, larger size, XL size. Okay. They will give the exact measurement details. But not always it will be accurate. But they will provide the size chart along with the sizes. Apart from these sizes, there will be size charts available. So I want you to do another activity. Okay, I want you to do another activity. That is, you can just take two online shopping websites. You can take Flipkart and Amazon. You can take Myntra and Flipkart, or you can just go for Ajio and something else. You can just this Bunai and Arch. Hello. So what were we discussing? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so what were we discussing?
Online website.
Online websites. So I was giving you some work to do, right? Okay. So just choose. You can go for Instagram shopping sites also. Okay, just go with those Instagram sites and check whether they are providing the size charts. And choose any two online shopping websites and compare them. Compare the size. Okay, compare the size chart they are providing. Okay. So compare both trousers and tops. Size chart for trousers and tops. Choose any two online websites and compare their sizes. Okay. So size chart is there. I can share one in the group. Okay. It is there. It is there. If you want, I can share one. Okay. Is that clear? Is the assignment clear? Okay. So, what is happening? So for example, so a large cross section of the population, I will share the screen. So in this you can see, in earlier times, everyone went to a tailor to get clothes made to one's own measurements. It is in modern times, due to changing economy, society and the world, that there is a growing demand for ready-to-wear apparel or ready-to-wear, which has made sizes and sizing systems very important. Right? Due to the introduction of ready-to-wear collection, the sizing and sizing system became very important, right? In order to manufacture garments with the right size. Yes, sizing systems are generally developed by the government or standardization organization that need to work out the standard sizes for the country. So in order to develop a standard size for a particular country, they will choose a sample group. Okay. They will choose a group of people who belongs to this particular age group, who is following this particular type of lifestyle and all. And they will choose a sample group. And they will measure the sample group, and that's how they will come up with a standard size for the country. But it will not be accurate for everyone, right? We all have different types of body types. Body forms. Okay. A large cross section of the population is measured to establish the standardized sizing system for the country, as I said. For example, it is British standards with BS 366. So the British standard is BS 366, which has established the sizing system for the British clothing industry. So all the shops selling garments or manufacturers for clothes. So those who manufacture clothes for the UK market should follow this sizing, BS 366 sizing, British standards. Okay. So the size is suffixed with S. You can see BS 366, right? So the S in it stands for short people. Short people. Those who are short. And if it comes like BT 366, then it is for tall people. The garment or the apparel line is for tall people. So when I go for shopping tops or kurtis or whatever, I'm forced to buy bigger sizes. I'm forced to buy bigger sizes because smaller sizes will be too small for me when it comes to length, because I'm tall. So I always used to buy XL and all double XL sizes so that it will have enough length. So this is a good thing, right? For tall people, a different size length, and for short people, a different size, standard size. So that is a good thing. But in Indian market, it is not there. Right? So in your text, you can see some sizes and measurements. There will be a chart in your textbook, or you can just see the chart. You can see the screen, right? There is a chart here. Like this, there will be a chart, a size chart in these online websites also. Okay. To make sure that you are buying the right size. Okay, so to make sure that you are buying the right size. So if you search these online websites, they are also providing size charts like this, where they will let you know what is the neck measurement, what is the chest measurement, what is the waist measurement, sleeve length, hip around, full length of the garment. And in some online websites, they will also provide the height information of the model. Okay, a model will be wearing these dresses, right? Am I right or wrong? A model will be wearing that particular piece of garment, and that picture will be showcased in all these online websites, apart from some. So some of these online websites also give us information about the height of the model so that we can calculate the length of that particular garment that she or he is wearing and how long it will be for us. In order to calculate all these things, they will also give us the height measurement of the that particular model. So is all these things clear? So in country like India and US, the body types of people in various parts and different ethnic group is so varied that the number of sized in sizing system need to be much more than three usual ones. So instead of small, medium and large, there will be extra small, small, medium, large and XL and extra, and double XL are also available in some cases, right? Because we discussed while in the chapter, while we were discussing history of fashion or unit 3, we were discussing about these measurements, different types of body types. So India, when it goes to northern region, women will be having much broader shoulder than hip area. And when it comes to south region, the woman will be having more of a hourglass levet or a larger hip. Okay. So it goes same with all the part. So some will be having broader shoulder, some will be having broader hip, like that. All of us are having different type body types. So it is very important to provide variety of sizes. And so because of which, when it comes to US market and Indian market, we have extra small, small, medium, large, extra large, and double XL. Okay. So if Is. What does it mean by is? Is. What can it be? Any idea? Ease of movement. Ease. Your garment should fit you properly, should not restrict you from performing certain activities, right? There is this armhole is there, shoulder line is there, this side seam is there, hem is there. So what happens if this ease is too tight? You will not be able to breathe, right? You will be standing like this after wearing that particular top or t-shirt. Will be too tight. What happened? The armhole is not comfortable. If it is not having proper ease, proper ease? While taking armhole measurement, I always tell that you should leave one thumb difference, right? You should start taking measurement after leaving one thumb measure, right? One thumb distance. So it is to make sure that the armhole or the sleeve will be comfortable for us to let us have all those hand movements. It will not restrict us with performing all this arm movement. Right. If you check your garment, if you check your piece of garment, the sleeve here, there will be extra space, right, in the armhole region, not in this knee region, not in this region, in this armhole region, extra is there, right? Am I right? Am I right or wrong? Just check your garment. Just check the garment or piece of top that you are wearing right now. Check. I want you to check and let me know what is happening. You can switch off your video and check yourself. Yes, what is the result? Are you guys there? Okay. Yes, what is the result? So in case of Nidhi, she is wearing a t-shirt, right? It is a stretchable fabric, so it stretches. So no need of leaving that ease or extra space over there because it stretches. It will automatically permit you for all those hand movements and all. So what about Meghna? She is wearing a kurti type top, right? A tunic or something. Yes, Meghna.
Yes, it have a little space for ease.
Little space, right? So what happened? You have the shoulder length, right? Shoulder length from neck to shoulder tip. That is there. So what happens if it is too short? What happens if your shoulder doesn't fit on that particular top? Yes, Meghna.
You won't be able to move your hand.
You will not be able to move your hands and the sleeves will just go like this, right? And it will be too tight, restricting your movements. Okay, So that is ease. That particular garment should be comfortable you to wear. So ease or tolerance in a pattern means acceptable margin, but there is a difference of ease of pattern and ease of comfort. Ease of comfort is different, ease of pattern is different. If the garment is designed in a particular way, in an oversized or a loose way, then that is different. Ease of comfort is different. This armhole, this shoulder, these are our ease of comfort. Each garment is made for a purpose, an outerwear. So what all are outerwears? Outerwears. What all are these outerwears? Hoodie, jackets, denim jacket. Jackets and all these are outerwears. We wear it over a particular garment, right? We will wear it over a particular garment. It's an outerwear, it's an overwear, right? So it should be, it should provide much more space than our usual piece of garment. We will be just wearing it over a petticoat or just our innerwear. But the hoodie or the jacket, we will wear it over this basic garment, right? So it should provide enough space to accommodate this particular garment, ourselves and this particular garment, right? So it should provide much more space. So that is different. What about innerwears? What about lingerie? You know what is a lingerie, right? Sunidhi, what is lingerie? Sorry, Nidhi?
Dress wear inside.
Yes, inner wears. Bra, panties, petticoat, sports bra, all these are lingerie, part of lingerie. Inner wear garments. So it should provide. So it's time for us to leave. So we will discuss the remaining things in the next class. We also have an afternoon session, right? So we will discuss the remaining topics there. Okay. Okay, thank you.